What's up, guys? I hope everyone's having a great day. Brian just got here. I saw his car outside. He's about to come in now. Hey, Brian. That's the motion sensor that says he's here. By the way, if you have not already subscribed, make sure you hit that subscribe button right now and join the winning family. Brian? Yeah? Here, just come in here real quick. We'll leave in a second. Did you see my vlog today? I got a Supreme gun. All right, guys, that was pretty good. I wish he didn't cuss on my vlog, but I don't think he knew I was recording. But look, it's Brian. He hasn't been in the video in a while, but cue the quick intro.
I'm balling.
So I got home from school. I had a little package waiting for me from the family over at Sandal Boys. Thank you so much to Franelations for these. I'm gonna wear these right now. Oops. All right, so as you guys know, every day this week leading up to my insane pop-up this Sunday, October 1st at Lace Up Hollywood, I'm gonna announce another detail. If you don't follow me on Instagram, I'm reposting a ton of the steals that they're talking about. I'm gonna do some steals out of my personal collection, which is why I'm gonna go to Urban Necessities today to pick up some stuff that was for sale there. I'm gonna go pick it up. And then also, I may as well just say it, another little thing. He, as well as Peyton, will be at the pop-up. Peyton is the cameraman who you guys saw two videos ago. He'll be the cameraman like for a lot of my videos upcoming. But yeah, right now we gotta head out to Urban Necessities. Let's go. Whoa. All right, so now I'm at Urban Necessities right now. Like I said, they redid the back of the store. If you'll notice, like from a lot of my old videos, it was like huge aisle here and then like huge aisle here. And now they got like lots of smaller ones, but they got lots of these smaller aisles, which is super sick. And look at that. It goes to the ceiling. Hypebeast heaven. So any of the shoes that I had here that I brought a long time ago, some of you guys might remember, any of the ones that didn't sell, I'm picking up right now. Let's just say this Sunday, Laced Up Hollywood, you might want to be there. All right, guys, so I just got home. It's been a while. I do some homework and all that kind of, you know, not so fun stuff, but the stuff that has to be done. And now there's been something that, like, I have planned for nights like these. I've noticed, like, different comments, different videos, like, asking me questions about different people, so I'm just going to kind of make a video about it. It's why you guys clicked on this video. My phone just came uncharged. It is the what like really big famous YouTubers, or not so like huge YouTubers but still pretty big YouTubers, are hype beasts in real life. Not like just people that collect sneakers or have a couple nice pieces of clothing, but who is genuinely a hype beast and who is just like kind of a sneakerhead. All right, so I'm gonna go on my Instagram and just kind of go through different people that I follow and see if they're a hype beast or if they're not a hype beast. This screen record thing on my phone is making it really laggy. Here, let me move over here so I have room to put my phone screen right there. Logan Paul, let's see. He's pretty big. Let's see, what shoes is he wearing? I don't even know what that is. Let's give him a couple more chances. Let's see what shoes. Air Force Flyknits, okay, it's definitely not hype beast, but like, okay, he's wearing the same Flyknits in a lot of these pictures. What's he got on here? Different pair of Flyknits. I would say Logan is not a hype beast. I mean, he could definitely afford to be if he wanted to. I just don't think he cares. All right, let's do Jake Paul next. Let's see. I'm pretty sure Jake's a hype beast. Let's see, what are these red shoes? Are those Red Octobers? I don't think those are. I don't know what those are. I know Jake does wear Yeezys a lot in real life. Let's see, this picture looks like that's Yeezys. And his buddies have Yeezys on as well. Yeah, Jake's like a half hype beast. Like, he just really likes Yeezys, I think. JC, hype beast. Like, super hype beast. JC is mega hype beast. Kais, what does the bio say? Biggest hype beast on YouTube? Maybe not biggest. I mean, I do have a Supreme motorcycle, but I don't know. Steph Curry's wife. I don't even know why I follow her. Blake Linder, hype beast. Rashid is like the king of hype beasts. Like, yeah, I might have a Supreme bike, but my man's has a Supreme Louis Vuitton Ferrari. Shout out to Rashid. That's not even close. Okay. None of those people are hype beasts. Boo, 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 boo. All right, let's check Tanner Fox. Is Tanner Fox a hype beast? Let's see. Okay, red human races. Okay, I see you. Yeezys right here. Okay. You know, I would say, I don't know these people in real life. Like, I don't know Tanner Fox at all. I've never met him, actually. He might be a hype beast, but he also just has, like, decent shoes. It's kind of just, I mean, he can afford to just buy the stuff that he sees on blogs, probably. Rice Gum. Every picture is hype. What's this? Gucci. Supreme BOGO. Yeah, Rice is super, super hype beastie. Wow, okay. Check out FaZe Banks. He's really hot on YouTube right now. I'll be honest, I don't actually watch him or follow. I'll follow him, why not? Let's see what he's working with. Oh shoot, Off-White Jordan 1s, okay. Gum 750s, okay, he's definitely hype beast. I might have to check out one of his videos. He's super hype beast. CJ so cool. Oh, that's tough. CJ is a huge sneakerhead. I don't know if he's a hype beast. Like, he doesn't wear Supreme Ron stuff like that. He loves designer stuff. I mean, he has zebras and creams, but I don't think he's a hype beast. So I would say CJ is not quite a hype beast. Let's check out Casey Neistat. I used to love Casey. I haven't watched him in a while, but I used to love him. I just kicked over a table over there. I used to love Casey Neistat. I mean, I still probably do. I don't know. I just haven't watched him in a while. See, the thing is, in his videos, he used to have, like, Supreme backpacks and, like, he'd have little Adidas runners here and there. I don't know if he's a hypebeast. I know the guy that sells him Supreme. Shout out to the Supreme Saint on Twitter. I've been talking to him a lot recently. I know that's the guy that hooks Casey up with all of his stuff, but I guess I would have to say no. Benjamin Kicks. He's not even a hypebeast. He's just, like, a money beast. Yeezy Busta. He's a hypebeast. I mean, like, his name's Yeezy Busta. That's my boy, though. Like, he's even stayed at the house before. Speaking of, I have one more collab that I filmed with him way back then that I've been just saving for, like, that one day where it's like, I want to just drop it. So, leave a like on this video if you want to see that video, and I will drop it. Joe Hayden of the Pittsburgh Steelers. I'm just going through people that I follow. Joe is a super big sneakerhead. I don't know if he's a hype beast, but he's got a lot of sneakers. He used to be more into it, but I don't know if he's a hypebeast. He's just more of a sneakerhead. All these people, like, don't care about shoes. Like, Joe Gatto from Impractical Jokers, he's not hypebeast. Shout out to you if you watch that show. I love that. Blazin' Dairy's a hypebeast. My boy Mike Conley. I actually follow him. I'm not a big Grizzlies fan, but I have met him. I've actually played golf with him, so, like, that's super cool. He's not really a hypebeast, but, like, he knows about shoes and stuff. Teddy's a hypebeast for sure. I'm not even going to click on that. Blau is actually a DJ who's pretty famous. I don't know if any of you guys listen to that kind of music, like EDM and stuff like that. But he actually went to the same high school I go to. He's actually a family friend, so I follow him. I know that he cares about shoes in real life. Like, oh, look, there's him in Hyperdaps performing in front of, like, what looks like all of my subscribers. He's not really a hypebeast, but he likes shoes. He likes shoes. My man Logic right here. I like Logic so much. I've been listening to his stuff. Like, I haven't met him, so I don't want to make it sound like I have, but, like, I've been listening to his stuff a lot recently. I really, really like him. It's like, huge shout out to him. Like, I like him more than a lot of other rappers, to be totally honest. He had that sneaker shopping video with Complex, but he didn't really come across as a hypebeast. I'd probably say he's just a sneakerhead. If he's even a sneakerhead. All right, so that is everyone I follow, and that's whether they are or are not a hype beast. Any sneaker YouTuber I didn't mention is probably a hype beast, just because, like, being a sneaker YouTuber, you kind of have to be a hype beast. Like, if all you do is buy stuff that no one likes, that isn't hyped, you're probably not getting views, meaning you guys probably don't watch them. I don't mean that in a mean way, but it's like, if you do nothing but buy, like, Fila or Skechers, like, you wouldn't get views. Like, Tony D's not super hype beastie, but, like, someone like, honestly, like myself, very, very hype beastie. Like, if it's hyped, I want it. If it's not hyped, like, I don't necessarily not want it, but, like, I like the hunt of going after that piece that's super hyped, that's like, oh shoot, if I can actually get this, that'd be sick. That's why I own a Supreme motorcycle. And because you guys left 20,000 likes on a video, which has never happened before until that day. All right, guys, so that is it for today's video. I know it was a shorter one. I know it was a bit more sit downy, which I don't really want to do, but tomorrow's vlog I had to do some preparation work for, along with some homework and stuff like that. But with that being said, guys, thank you as always for watching. Make sure, if you've not already, you subscribe, join the winning family, leave a like on this video, comment down below if I will see you Sunday, October the 1st at Laced Up Hollywood at the Glendale Galleria Mall in Los Angeles. And I read something, like, I want to say it was 2 or 3 days ago, and I've been meaning to share with you guys, so I wanted to share with you guys. There's a quote I actually saw on Logic's Twitter, because I followed him, and I don't know, I'm on this, like, weird Logic kick, but I really like a lot of the stuff he stands for, and he said a quote, and I don't want to get it wrong, so it's, "How can the sky be the limit when there are footprints on the moon?" That is, like, the most fire quote I've ever read. That's actually probably the second most fire quote I've ever heard in my life, because I will see you guys tomorrow. Stay winning and make it happen, fam. That's the best one. Peace.